Today, it's time for the Smartphone Durability Awards. It feels good to close out 2020. 2020 has been pretty crazy, but it's also been really good. 2020 is the year that we launched the Rig, our not a wheelchair. That's been a pretty huge project for my wife and I. Dbrand and I also gave away 100 phones to you guys and donated over 30 TVs to different hospitals and schools. We even built a school in Africa with your guys' help. That was back in January before the whole pandemic started. I also built a huge raised flower garden for my wife, and 3D printed a massive concrete statue of myself, and also got a close-up look at some awesome new electric vehicles, and even installed some solar panels on the roof of my house, which I'll definitely be doing a follow-up video on here in a few months. It's been a really big year, and of course we've durability tested and torn down quite a few phones along the way, and today it's time for the 2020 Smartphone Durability Awards. Let's get started. Let's start with the most repairable smartphone of 2020, and that award goes to the Google Pixel 5, mostly because there are zero screws required to remove to replace the screen. A skilled technician could replace the screen on the Google Pixel 5 in about 60 seconds, using just a heat plate, a suction cup, and a pry tool. Plus, there's a layer between the screen and the internals, so you don't damage any of the other fragile electronics while you're working around inside of there. It's pretty cool how Google was able to engineer such an easy screen replacement on the Google Pixel 5, so it wins the most repairable screen repair of 2020. The least repairable smartphone, however, has got to go to the Black Shark 3. This is actually kind of a funny story. My wife and I planned on doing like an April Fool's video, and so she was the one who took this apart. We had no idea how difficult it was going to be. The different components of this phone are intertwined throughout the frame with multiple heat pipes, and it's pretty crazy inside. She was a trooper though, and she managed to put it all back together in one piece, but it's still the most difficult to repair smartphone of 2020. It was super difficult to pick the most innovative smartphone of 2020. You would think that during a pandemic the innovation would kind of slow down, but this has been one of the most fun years for smartphones we've had in a long time. One of my favorites has been the LG Wing, which has a screen on the front that opens up into like a T-shape with a secondary screen underneath. It's something we never thought we wanted and probably still don't need, but it's still innovative and pretty cool. Then of course we have all the folding phones this year. They are much more durable and they have the glass layer underneath that plastic screen, which is pretty cool. The most innovative smartphone of 2020, in my opinion, has got to be the Axon 20 with its underscreen camera. Flippy screens are cool, fans are cool, but in the future, most smartphones I think are going to be utilizing the technology that we first saw in this Axon 20. And as you know, if you've been around on my channel for a while, we take apart every single smartphone to see what it looks like from the inside and how easy it is to repair. And the best looking smartphone of 2020, once again, it was hard to choose, but in my opinion, that has to go to the iPhone 12 Pro Max. It's hard to argue with the aesthetics of the MagSafe charger. Remember, it uses those magnets around the wireless charging coil. The blend of the copper and the magnets just looks pretty good. Not to mention the special sensor shift up here in the top camera sensor. I don't always use Apple and innovative in the same sentence, but this year they've done a pretty good job with the iPhone. I do think that the Note 20 Ultra comes in a close second with its dual-colored motherboard, but I still have to say that the best-looking phone from the inside has got to be the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Now, when we talk about the least durable smartphones of 2020, we kind of have a predicament, because we have two categories of smartphones. We have the normal glass rectangles, and it's pretty safe to say we have reasonable expectations of durability from these normal shaped smartphones. But this year, along with last year, we have a new category of folding phones, and that reasonable expectation of durability isn't the same, since we're not really expecting a folding phone to be durable. Now, they are much more durable than we initially anticipated, or at least for me. Bending the Galaxy Z Flip or the Galaxy Fold in half is impossible with how sturdy their hinge is. But as far as the screen goes, it's still super soft and not as durable as a normal rectangular smartphone. So the folding phones get a pass for this year, but as they get more popular and more common, we'll start ranking them individually as well. They are still some of the most fun phones to take apart and see how they work. This is the Galaxy Z Flip. We have the Galaxy Fold right here, as well as the Moto Razr, which didn't get, he's just seen better days. Out of the smartphones that do have a reasonable expectation of durability, we have the Lite Phone 2 that kind of snapped into little bits. It's super interesting to see the e-ink display is still lit, even after being destroyed. That technology is super interesting. But the Lite Phone 2 still isn't a real smartphone. The OnePlus Nord, however, did break entirely. The glass on the screen didn't crack, and the glass on the back didn't crack, but the screen underneath the glass is destroyed, making the phone unusable after my durability test. So unfortunately, the OnePlus Nord wins the least durable smartphone of 2020. It's not the award you want to win. Another award you don't want to win is a new one that I'm starting this year called the Delusive Award. We know that every smartphone manufacturer will hype up their devices as much as they can. You know, it's called marketing, and everyone does it to some degree. Car manufacturers, people on dating apps, politicians, resumes, we all do it a little bit. But there is a point where that hype goes too far and steps into fantasy land. Samsung did toe the line with their folding glass on their folding phones this year, where the folding glass turned out to be a super tiny thin layer underneath all the layers of plastic. Delusive means kind of misleading, not entirely truthful. They also towed the line with their Exynos and Qualcomm fiasco. But there was a smartphone manufacturer that advertised over and over and over again that their smartphone had a 100% recycled aluminum encasing, which makes people think that the entire phone is made out of aluminum or has a metal body, when in reality that metal was a skeleton hidden underneath a very thick layer of plastic. Once again, the advertising wasn't technically a lie, it was just creative enough that led people to think it was something else than what it was, hence the delusive part. The most delusive smartphone of 2020 was also the Google Pixel 5. You can see the super thick layer of plastic surrounding that metal skeleton that Google just conveniently didn't really mention. The Google Pixel 5 is also the most repairable smartphone of 2020, so you win some and you lose some. The Delusive Award is not an award you want to win, and I hope I don't have to give it out next year. Now for the most durable smartphone of 2020. Most phones do survive my durability tests. Back in 2016, when I first started these durability awards, we had multiple phones snap in half. But most phones these days are very solidly constructed, rigid, and just generally well-built smartphones. I can't say for certain if my videos helped in that quality improvement, but accountability is a good thing. Pretty much every smartphone released this year has glass on both sides, and as we know, glass is glass and glass can break. And even though glass feels premium, it's never going to be durable, especially when companies like Apple are charging over $500 to replace the back glass on the iPhone 12 Pros. So I can't choose a glass-backed phone to be the most durable. The most durable smartphone, naked, right out of the box, of 2020 has got to be the Pixel 4a. It's intentionally advertised as plastic, but it's still strong enough to withstand my durability test. And as a bonus, it's designed in almost the same way as the Google Pixel 5, with its super easy to swap screen. And if that wasn't enough, it's also one of the cheapest phones on this table, as well as one of the few phones with a headphone jack. So the most durable smartphone of 2020 goes to the Google Pixel 4a. Now don't get me wrong, any of these smartphones on this table can be considered the most durable smartphone of 2020 if they have a case and a screen protector. The takeaway from these durability tests and teardowns are that most smartphones are really good, and if you treat them nice, they're going to last for quite a while. So having protection on your phone is a good thing. It can save you hundreds of dollars down the road when you don't have to buy a new phone, because it's not broken. I used my last phone for about 3 years, and I always had a case on it, and I've had this Galaxy Note 10 Plus for about a year now, a little over a year, and I have no intentions of upgrading in the near future. Because as smartphones get better, they stay relevant for longer. And that's it, the Smartphone Durability Awards of 2020. We had some awesome phones this year, and I'm excited to see what 2021 will bring us. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. As you can see, we have quite a lot of fun around here. Come hang out with me on Instagram and Twitter, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.